Assalamu alaykum, this is Lailani Niqabi and welcome back to my channel. Inshallah, you guys are all doing well. I am okay, alhamdulillah. Oh my gosh. I just got off from work about maybe 30 minutes to 45 minutes ago. And I have been trying to figure out what to talk to you guys about. I have no idea. I've been thinking every day, oh my gosh, what's going to be my topic? What am I going to talk about? What am I going to share? And I couldn't come up with anything. SubhanAllah. So, I'm just going to talk. I'm just going to ramble. And, but definitely, if you guys have any suggestions about... Ooh, my glasses are so dirty. If you guys have any suggestions, you know, about what I can talk about, like, you know, if you have any questions, you know, where am I from and all that stuff, you know, feel free to leave a comment. You know, nice questions, not rude. I will not respond to any rude questions. So you can forget about that. Thank you. But anyways, inshallah, you guys are doing well. Oh, that's much better. All right. So me. Let's see. Well, I go to work because I just got off work not too long ago. And it was a good day. You know, alhamdulillah. Wasn't too busy. Wasn't too bad. My God, I'm in California, so it's really, really hot. The last time I looked at the temperature on my phone, it said it was about 103, and it's supposed to get to about a high of 107. So, in my translation of it, it's going to be about a bajillion degrees outside, and it's already, you know, close to that right now. So I don't like the heat. And, you know, for us Niqabis out there, it's not very easy for us, you know. So, because we're, you know, so hot and we're sweating and, you know, our Niqabs, depending on the colors, I've started just sticking with the black Niqab. Why? Because you can't see very much of sweat, you know, on your nose or whatever. So you can get away with it. but if you're wearing like a lighter color niqab, you may be able to see it a lot more pronounced than you would with a darker niqab. So I've been sticking with the black for a while. So inshallah, I'll be able to wear other colors, but so long as it's hot. Oh gosh, no. Let's see. Oh, I make Muslima dolls. I've been making them for a few years, actually. I want to say since 2008 or 9-ish. The dolls I used to make had, you know, drawn faces. But I don't do that anymore. Every time I, you know, show a doll that I do, or a sister sees a doll or something, they're very concerned about the drawing of images on the dolls. And I've come across some hadith and some scholarly opinions regarding the drawing of faces on the dolls. And some sisters have been very concerned about, you know, me drawing sin upon myself because I'm creating an image of something, you know, of a like a human being image on a doll. So, you know, because of those concerns of that, I've decided not to do it. I decided not to draw faces. I still do the dolls, alhamdulillah. I love doing it. Oh my gosh, I love making the dolls. I love doing that. But I won't do the faces anymore like I used to. And I have an example of a doll that I made. Now, this one is, this one is a little Maryam doll. Now, she's, you know, fair complected, and she's wearing, as you see, a black abaya, black hijab with the pink trim around the sleeves, around the bottom of the abaya and the bottom of the hijab. And if you take the hijab off, bad hair day. Okay, take the hijab off, you can see that she's got two ponytails, you know, brown ponytails, pink bow, you know, pink ribbon bow, whatever. So this is what she looks like without the hijab. I love doing these dolls, mashallah. I love doing them. I love, 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 love doing them. I think they're the most fun thing ever for me. And what makes me even happy is when I get an order, and sometimes I get a story behind why the sister is ordering it. You know, for example, one sister said she was going to be adopting a little girl from another country, and so she wanted to be able to have a doll for her. Now, she never did complete the order, so inshallah everything is okay, and you know, the adoption is going to go all right. I was really looking forward to it, and it just warmed my heart, the story behind why she was ordering the dolls. And then I had a sister here in Sacramento. She ordered two dolls for her two little girls, you know, one doll each. And they're so precious. She and her little daughters came by to pick up the dolls, and it was for an Eid gift, for Eid al-Fitr. And they're so adorable, mashallah. But she took a picture of the dolls, you know, of her daughters with the dolls, and she said that ever since they got the dolls, they sleep with them, they go everywhere with them, and they even gave them, they have Muslim names, but they even gave them American names, alhamdulillah. And it's so cute, and they look so cute with the dolls, and that just warms my heart up. I just love it, because that's why I do it. I do it because I love to know that, you know, once the doll gets into the little girl's arms, they're just gonna love it and love it and love it so much. And it just made me so happy when she sent me a picture of the girls smiling and all happy about their gift. So I love doing it. Though I have a website, and I'll just leave it. I'll leave it in the description box, actually. The website for my dolls. So if sisters, brothers, if you have, you know, little daughters, nieces, or granddaughters, or you have friends with little girls and you want to order a doll for them, you can go onto my website and do so. So I'm still taking orders. I'm not getting a lot, you know, but, you know, I get so happy when I get an order, whether it be on the website or on Facebook, because I also sell them on Facebook, you know, make them available there too. So on there, I got them. I got a few orders from there. So alhamdulillah, but I love doing it. I love doing it. It's so fun. It's so fun. I changed the design of it and of how I did it before, so where it's easy for me to put it together, but I love making them. And my daughter, she was the inspiration behind me making them, because living in the U.S., there's not a lot of places to get halal, you know, toys. And so I wanted to make a doll for her that, you know, that looked like her, and wore hijab just like her, and, you know, wore modest dress just like her. So I didn't find anything on the website. This was a few years ago. There was a website that does sell dolls, but with the face, the way they did it, it looked so creepy. It freaked me out. And I'm not the kind of person, I don't particularly like dolls with, you know, questionable faces that kind of freak you out. It freaked me out. Kind of reminded me of like the halal version of a Chucky. I don't know. But it freaked me out. I didn't like it. So, yeah. But she had all of my prototypes. And then I made her one for her birthday years ago. And she still has it to this day. And she's not that old. She's, you know, 11. Alhamdulillah. So she has all of my prototype dolls that I've made before. So, but I like making them. So if you want to order, just go onto my website. The website will be in the description box. Okay, what else? I like making body butters for myself and my daughter. So I like to kind of experiment. I've been on this natural ingredient kick. And, you know, believe it or not, YouTube happened to bring me onto it. There's, you know, some sisters or ladies out there that, you know, have YouTube channels where they show how they make, you know, natural products like body butters and body oils and hair pomades and things like that. So I like making body butters. I go onto a website that Natural 85 had goes on to for her natural ingredients. And yes, I watched Natural 85. So I order some of my, I actually order all of my ingredients from there. And then I go to, you know, Whole Foods to pick up some essential oils that I may not be able to find online to mix in with, you know, my concoctions. So that's fun. I also make homemade deodorant, and I have to thank my sister-in-law, because she posted on her Facebook page that she made deodorant for my brother, and then that's what got me interested in making deodorant. So I started making deodorant. I wrote a recipe down for one deodorant where I use coconut oil, but I think that one will be best for winter time because it doesn't melt as quickly or as used up as quickly, because when you touch it at the touch of the skin, it kind of, you know, warms very quickly to the touch of the skin. And so I think that'll be better for the winter time, because then it'll be a lot more solid and probably won't go on so, you know, I don't know. I don't want to say runny. I don't know. But I like that. I did make another one using using cocoa butter. And that one is, I think that is good for summer, like now, because it's a little bit it's not harder to melt at the touch of the skin. It just goes on a lot easier because of course you have the warmth of the weather and the warmth of the skin. You don't want it to, like, when you put it on, it's just like that. So I like that. And to be, you know what, I need to make my daughter some, because she ran out. And yes, she's 11, but under those arms, it's getting pretty, you know, ew. So I have to make her some. And I think when I make some, I may show you guys, inshallah, what I use and how much I use. So inshallah, that's a topic right there. How I make deodorant. Anyway. So I like doing that. Oh, and another thing I started doing, I started making almond milk. I didn't like the stores. I've tried the almond milk. I think I tried two different kinds of almond milk and I just didn't like it. So guess who got me into making that? Oh, there's, what is her name? Hey Fran, her channel. She shows how she makes almond milk. Is it Hey Fran? I think it's the YouTube channel, Hey Fran. Yeah, she shows how to make, you know, natural products and using natural things for like cleaning your skin and how to make lip balm. And yes. She did show how to make almond milk. So she turned me on to making my own almond milk. So I went to World Market here in Sacramento and I bought two glass milk jars or milk jugs. And they're really nice, actually. Kind of reminds me of, you know, maybe like the 1910s or 1920s where, you know, the milkman would come out and deliver milk at everyone's door. The old fashioned. So I bought two milk bottles and so now I start making my almond milk. So I may show you guys how to do that too. Yep, I think I'll do that. And with that one, I use, of course, almonds. that's a dead giveaway. I use almonds. I soak a cup of almonds for 1 or 2 days, depending on how quickly I want to make it or how lazy I am. If I'm lazy, I may leave it in there for 2 days. 3 days at the max. No more than three. Why? I don't know. I just don't want to leave it for 3 days. I don't know what's going to happen. No more than 3 days. So I soak it and I drain it and I put it in a blender. And you guys, it's been a long time since I've had a blender. And so I did not realize how loud a blender can actually be. Oh my gosh, like, I hate it. I don't like noise. I don't like noise at all. But yeah, I put it in the blender, 4 cups of water. I put a couple of dashes of cinnamon and honey. And if I have any dates, I will cut up maybe six to eight dates and put it in there because I like the sweetness of the honey and the dates. I haven't had any dates for a few weeks, so I've been using honey and agave nectar. It's really good, mashallah. So I blend all of that up and you see it goes from like a water, you know, clear water consistency to now it's just, you know, milk. That's the amazing part. And then I take a cheesecloth, put the cheesecloth in a bowl, or I'll show you guys. I don't need to go through all this right now. I can show you guys later. But yeah, I make my own almond milk, and I've been doing it for a month and a half, 2 months, around that time. I like doing it. I tried to get my daughter to try the almond milk. She's a bit scary, just like I'm a bit scary trying new things. I also made chocolate almond milk. Ooh, that was really good. Not good when you're eating cereal with it, you know, but regular almond milk is good for that, for cereal. But chocolate almond milk is too sweet. Can't handle that. It's good on its own. So I will show you guys, inshallah, how to do that. That's another good topic. And then, you know, after you drain the almond milk, you have the pulp of the almond pulp left over. Oh, that doesn't go to waste. Oh no, No. I save that stuff. I use one, you know, I use some of it to put in, like, well, it's supposed to be meatloaf. It didn't come out that way because I forgot a crucial ingredient, egg. But it turned out really well. My daughter loved it, so I did it again without the bread or egg, actually, without the egg, and it was still really good. Maybe I might show you guys how to do that too. Instead of calling it meat loaf, I called it meat crumble, because that's basically what it did. But it was so good though. Alhamdulillah. Yeah. Oh, and I just recently made, with the almond pulp, I was gonna do muffins, but because I just recently moved and I got rid of, you know, a lot of stuff. The muffin pans being one of them because it didn't look really good and I was planning on getting new ones anyway. Instead of doing muffins, I did a loaf. And I did it using the almond pulp that had the chocolate, you know, the remnants of the chocolate chips in there when I was making the chocolate almond milk. Oh my gosh, the stuff was so good. I mean, we had it for like a breakfast and and then we had it as a afternoon lunch, and then we had it as a dessert after dinner. Yeah, we loved it. I have another loaf, and it's in the refrigerator, waiting for us, calling our names, come and eat me. I'll show you guys how to do that one too, inshallah. Oh gosh, I'm sitting there like wondering, what in the world am I gonna talk about? No topic. And here I am coming up with these ideas that I can do for the next video, inshallah. Yeah, I like to sew. If I get an idea for something, I'll make something. I just recently tried a to make a I want to say a jumper. A one-piece jumper, good for like everyday lounging around, you know, the house. Yeah. The top part didn't come out very well. I have to work on the top part. The bottom part, the pants, it was nice. Very, very, very nice and looked very comfortable. It is very comfortable, as a matter of fact. But yeah. I don't know what else. Eventually, inshallah, I'll come up with something else to talk to you guys about. But I just thought I'd come on here and just, you know, talk to you guys for a little bit, you know, tell you what I'm doing, what I've been doing. Today's, like I said, today's a hot day. I had to turn the air on. I figured if I'm gonna be recording and I don't have the air on, it's gonna be murderously hot under this niqab. So, yeah. Sisters, how are you guys doing? How many of you guys wear niqab, and how has your life been in niqab? Where do you go? What do you do? Do you do anything different? You know, go like hiking or I don't know. I mean, what do you guys do? Definitely leave a comment below. I'd like to know what you guys do. And what do you guys like to make? Do you make anything using natural ingredients like, you know, deodorant, lotions, or do you, what foods do you like to make? I'd like to know that. Yeah, just talk to me about something. Tell me what you like to do. And inshallah, next week I'll have something to talk about. Or even show you guys what I like to do, or I like to make. Maybe starting with the, I don't know, body butter? Because we're good on that. I don't need to make any more. We're good on that. Deodorant, maybe the thing I show you guys next week, inshallah. Because my daughter needs deodorant. No, she needs it now, so I don't think that's gonna be the case. Really, underneath the armpits is like whoosh. She's gonna need that now. I don't think she's gonna wait till next week. Maybe I can make it this weekend and then upload it for you guys to see next week. What do you think? Or I can show you how to make almond milk. Or chocolate almond milk. And a loaf. Yeah. Something. Anyways, well, thank you guys for joining me today. I know this is like a rambling session. Ramble, 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 rambling session. Mm-hmm. Anyways, I just heard the Adhan go off for Asr. It's time for me to go pray. So give my video a thumbs up. Like my video. Share my video with other sisters. And subscribe if you have not subscribed yet. And leave nice comments. Tell me what you guys are doing. What do you guys like to do? Leave the comments below. And I'll leave my website and my Facebook page for the dolls that I make. By the way, it's called Little Muslima. Little Muslima. So, alright, I gotta go. I have to get ready to pray. So, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Be blessed.